Hi students, let us continue with the subject database management system. So the next topic in this DBMS is, let us see the architecture of DBMS. So before going to know about the architecture of the DBMS, first of all you have to know the three levels that are present in the database management system. The three levels that are present in DBMS are external level, conceptual level, and internal level. So this external level is also called as view level. So we can call it as a view level, means we are seeing the user can able to interact with this external level, the view level. And the conceptual level, another name of conceptual level is the logical level. Whereas internal level is nothing but a storage level or a physical level. So this is view level. So in between the view and the storage, you are having the logical level. Now let us see the one by one. So what is the first one? External level. So external level, this level describes that part of the database that is relevant to each user. Let me write. This external level describes, what it describes? It describes that part of database that is relevant, means that database is relevant to each user. So it mainly holds that information that is relevant to the user, that you call it as external level. So the next is the conceptual level, also called as logical level. So conceptual level means here this level describes what data is stored, in database, and relationship. I already said about this. This conceptual level means the logical level mainly depends upon the relationship among the data. So it describes the relationship among the data that is present in the database. So this level describes what data is stored in database and relationship among the data. So it represents like the examples for this. It represents all entities, attributes, and their relationships. And also the constraints on the data. It also represents the constraints on the data, and it describes about the security and integrity information also. So this is about the conceptual level. Now let us see the next level. So the next level is the third level, what I said, this is the internal level. So internal level is also called as the storage level. So what is the internal level that is in the database management system? So this is, it is physical representation of database. So you have to know that internal level is nothing but is a physical representation of database. So what this level describes? This level describes how the data, so in conceptual we said what data is stored, what type of data is stored is tell by the logical level, that is a conceptual level, whereas the internal level describes how the data is stored, how the data is stored in database, and also it covers, this internal level covers the data structures and file organizations used to store the data on storage devices. So this is about the three levels that are present in the database management system architecture. So the architecture always divided into the layers. So that is the three level layers, external level, internal level, and the conceptual level. So actually, a DBMS can be seen, database management system can be seen as either single tier or multi-tier. So you can maintain the database management system either in a single tier or multi-tier. You can see whatever the software that are using, the database management system software, that software can maintain a single tier or multi-tier. So normally an entire architecture divides the whole system. So whatever the database system that you are using, it divides the entire architecture, divides the whole system into related but independent end modules. So one thing you have to be noted here is, so if you take the entire architecture, this entire architecture is also divides the architecture into layers, different layers. So whenever it divides into layers, those will be independent to each other. Their whole system into relation, the relation will be there. One level is related to the another level, means a mapping condition will be there between the levels, between the architecture. Okay, but independent modules means whatever the modifications that are done in one level does not affect with the upper level. It does not affect the upper level. So here the database management system always follows the entire architecture, and it also divides the whole system into related but independent end modules. So here, which can be independently modified, altered, changed, or replaced. So let us see what is this tier architecture. So how this database management system will be divided into different tiers. So what this each tier will indicate. Let us see the first one tier architecture. So the database management system structure, I mean system, can be seen either in single tier or multi-tier, I said. So let us take a one-tier architecture. One-tier architecture means here the systems will be there. So these are the different systems, and here one server will be there. So this you call it as a file server. So in one tier architecture, rather than going for the database server, we'll use the file server. So these are all the client computers. So the client computers will interact with the file server. So this is only the one tier architecture. One tier means only one server is there. So many clients and one server is there. So if it is one server is there, you call it as a one tier architecture. So here only the user interface will be there, user interface, and it depends upon the presentation service and application service. So one tier architecture means only you can go for the file servers rather than database servers. One tier client and the system communication, a communication between the client and the file server. Okay, so mostly one-tier architecture will be used at the places whenever you are not supposed to change the data frequently, whenever there are no multiple users or accessing the system. So in that cases, you will prefer, you can go for the one-tier architecture. Now let us see the next two-tier architecture. So let us see the two-tier. Let me, I have written spelling wrong. Architecture. So let us see the two-tier architecture. So two-tier architecture means you are having the client computers. So these client computers are interacting with the database servers. It's not the file server. It is database server. So this is called as a client tier. You call it as a client tier. And here this is the database tier. So here interaction will be there. And these are the client computers. Okay, so this is a two-tier architecture. Two-tier will be there. So this you call it as A. It is a client server architecture. The another name of the two-tier architecture is the client server architecture. So here a direct communication will be there. Direct communication is there. And also one of the advantage of using two-tier architecture is it runs faster when compared to one-tier. So in the one-tier we are using only the client computer and the file server. But here we are using the database server. So in a single, if you are using the applications in a within an organization, it's better to go two-tier architecture. So within an organization, you are having the database server. This database server is communicating with the all the clients in that organization, or all the clients that are present in the another organization. Okay, so the two-tier architecture, only the difference between one-tier and two-tier is there. One system, one client is communicating with the only the file server, whereas in two-tier, all the clients will communicate with the database server which is present in the organization. Now coming to the third one, three-tier architecture. So nowadays everyone will be following this three-tier architecture. So this three-tier architecture is completely depends upon the networking on the internet, and it is a web-based application. This three-tier architecture follows the web-based applications, and it is depends completely. Now it everything is, the three-tier is on cloud. Now let us see what is this three-tier. Three-tier means three layers will be there. Here only two will be there. Here three layers will be there. So these are the client tier. Means client computers will be there. Next is the so this you call it as a business logic tier. This is a middle tier. You also call it as a the three middle tier, business logic tier. So which consisting of the application servers. So here in the middle tier application servers will store. After that, this is the database server, database tier. So three tiers will be there: client tier, business logic tier, and the database tier. So here each computers, all the client computers first interacting with the application server. So then the application server will interact with the database server. So a three layer structure is this. the main points in the three-tier architecture is it separates. It separates tiers from each other. From each other. Based on complexity, based on complexity of the users and how the user and how they use the data present in database. So it's completely depend upon the usage of the data present in database by the user. So and next, it is completely, as I said, it is a web-based application. Completely web-based application. So here some client types, client systems will be there. That is somewhere in another place. And this is the business logic tier, which is there in the organization. And this is the database server, which is present. Nowadays, it is present on the cloud. Okay. So it follows the three-tier architecture. A three layers will be there here. A three layers. One is the client layer. And the next is the business layer. And the next is the data layer. So data layer where data will be stored in the database. Let us see what is this. Let me explain this three-tier architecture more clearly. So the first, the least layer is the database layer. You call it as a database tier, that is data tier. So what this, what information will be stored here? This database resides along with its query, processing language. So the data that is present on the database will be resides with the help of the query processing language. So here the data and their constraints stored in. Next, coming to the application. The middle layer is the application tier. Or middle. Application tier. So what is there in this middle? So here this is the middle layer. Business logic tier. This middle application tier mainly consists of, it's suppose for a user, this present an abstract view of database. So for users, this application middle tier presents an abstract view of database and acts as a mediator between the, and also it acts as mediator between user, that is the end user, and database. At another end of the database, means at another end of the this business logic tier, you are having the database. So here the database tier is not aware of any other user. He is not aware of any other user beyond the application tier. So this, you have to remember that the database, what is present here, this server does not, it's not aware of any other user beyond the application tier. So it only knows about who is accessing, means only the application tier it will know. So that is about this application tier. Now coming to the last, that is the client tier. You call it as a user or presentation tier. So what is this user or presentation tier? Here the end user operate on this tier and they know nothing about any existence of database beyond this layer. So this is the client tire. So this is a user no operates on this tire. The end user is operating on this tire, and this end user doesn't know anything about the existence of database beyond this layer. Means beyond this user tire, the end user doesn't know what's happening inside the database or in what happening in the application layer. So here the multiple views of database can be provided by the application. Thank you.